Hi friends, welcome to another episode of ZipTalks. Today we have with us a very special guest, Ms. Manisha Girotra. She is the Chief Executive Officer of Moelis India. With over 25 years of investment banking experience, she is also the former CEO and country head of UBS in India. She has featured in Business Today's 25 Most Powerful Women in Business in India for 6 years, and Fortune India's 50 Most Influential and Powerful Women in 2014 and 2018. She also currently serves on the boards of Ashok Leyland, Mindtree, Jio Payments Bank, and Naspers. Welcome, Manisha. It's such a pleasure to have you on the show. I have been such a big fan of yours. I've been in the same industry. You've been in investment banking. I was in markets, and I've seen how you have navigated your career and reached the success that you have done. What an inspiration to all of us. Really, thank you so much for being on the show.
Thank you, Radha. That's very kind of you. And I think it's only us women who lift each other up. So thank you for your kind words. And by the way, I'm really impressed by what you're doing with this show. Through this show and the episodes I've watched, I realized how fit you are. And I really admire that because, you know, I know it takes a lot to get yourself to exercise when you lead a corporate life. And I think the fact that you just do it naturally and have made it a way of life is really inspiring. Well done.
Thank you so much. Thank you. Thank you for your kind words. So I'm going to start by asking you about what is your fitness philosophy? I would love to ask you lots of questions on your career, but given this show is about how important fitness plays a role in successful people's lives, I'm going to ask you about your fitness philosophy.
So Radha, I grew up in the mountains. I grew up in Simla, and you know, so the way of life was basically walking. It was a lot of exercise, a lot of walking. That was just how we lived. There were no cars. You just had to climb the mountains. We were active trekkers. My father is an absolute passionate golfer, and he instilled that in me and my brother. So sports was a really active way of life. When I joined the corporate world, I think a lot of my exercise plan took a backseat. Other than walking, which I love to do, and I wear my shoes and go everywhere, everything else took a backseat just because life overtook everything. And, you know, I just couldn't keep up. And I think when I switched my careers from UBS to Moelis, I had a 5-month gardening leave, and I really went back to exercising. And now, other than walking, which I said I love to do, I can wear my pair of walking shoes and go anywhere and walk anytime. I like to do yoga. I like to do Pilates. So that's kind of my exercise schedule. I don't think it's as intense as yours. It's about 3 to 4 times a week. It's not a very impressive schedule, but I think it works for me.
Okay, that's what's important. Like you said, it is what works for you. I think everybody's body is different. Everybody's lives are different. Their schedules are different. But if you've managed to find a routine that works for you, I think that is incredible. But as career women, you know, you're a wife, a mother, a career woman, hectic lives. How do you manage to find a work-life balance? How do you cope? I mean, we all go through stresses, right? I've also been a banker for 25 years. So how have you managed to bring that work-life balance into your life?
So as you said it, I think our lives are really tough, right? I mean, being bankers and especially investment bankers, it's very chaotic. It's very erratic. When a deal is live, you're working Saturdays, Sundays, Monday through Friday, late hours. You're traveling at the drop of a hat to wherever the client wants you to. So it can really take a toll on your body. And in addition to that, being a working mom, you have additional roles, and you know, you tend to multitask as a way of life. Now, all that is great. We all, you and I and all other working women, we pride ourselves in being multitaskers. But you know, while that is great, and I don't think my husband could multitask even 2 things if I asked him to do it, he would collapse. He would be like, this is not my role. Well, I can do like 5 things, and I pride myself on that. But I think what it does take a toll on your body and your mind, right? Because you're constantly switched on, you're constantly plugged on, right? You're Yes. thinking about the house or the child or the work and, you know, multiple other things, your parents, etc., if they're aging. So I think all of that takes a toll. And that's why, you know, it's very important to have some me time. And by me time, I don't mean the time that you spend playing Scrabble with your children. If that's what you love the most, that's great. But if there's something that you love much more, which is, you know, whether it's exercising, like in your case, playing golf in my case, listening to music in my case, I brought that back into my life in the last 8 years. And I think that made a huge difference. Not too much time. It could just be like a couple of hours on the weekend or 20 minutes in a weekday, or listen to music while driving to work. just things that I enjoy doing. And I think that really changed perspective for me. It just gave me a little bit more, you know, self-respect for myself and a little bit, you know, the fact that I count too, you know, not just as a mom, as a daughter, but just me for myself. And I think that really restored a lot of balance into my life.
I think the point you made about me time is so important. A lot of women feel guilty about doing that. Yes. But I think it is so important to be able to find that me time. And what is it that will help you de-stress and help you relax? Because if you're relaxed and calm, you're way more effective at work. You're way more effective as a mother, as a wife. And I think we women have to stop feeling guilty about taking out that me time.
Exactly. I think we're programmed to guilt. We're brought up by perfectionist moms, you and I, right? Our moms are perfect moms, perfect wives. So I think we are constantly programmed to be guilty. And I think that just takes away from our efficiency so much. And that's why bringing in some of the me time, I think, brings back perspective, you know, and helps you feel de-stressed and be much more efficient. I think you're far more effective than in managing your work-life balance or whatever it is that you do, just by spending some time doing things you and I love to do.
Yes. No, I think that's such an important point, and I'm so glad you spoke about it. Moving on from me time, you know, I've been a part-time blogger and I've written blogs on what I think are like the four pillars which I follow when it comes to my health and fitness, and that's exercise, nutrition, sleep, and stress. Nothing new, nothing extraordinary, but you know, things which we forget to focus on. And when I was writing on stress, I came across a lot of TED Talks and articles while I was doing research on positive optimism and what an important role that plays. And recently you and I were having a chat on that, and I thought I have to ask you to speak about how do you always look so happy, have this positive, optimistic attitude, and are always smiling. So what is it that, and how important do you really think it is for our health and well-being?
So I totally agree with you. As you and I discussed, Radha, I think it's the most important thing in our journey in corporate life, because corporate life is extremely tough, competitive, not just competitive externally. You can have competition within your team, within colleagues. And I think through all of that, you just have to keep perspective. You just have to stay positive, stay optimistic, stay happy. My grandfather used to always say, take your work seriously, but don't take yourself so seriously. And, you know, I see today people get really bogged down. When is my next promotion? When is my next pay rise? Why is my bonus 5% lower than the other person's? You know, at the end of the day, your career is your marathon. It's not a sprint. It's your journey. And through that journey, if you're just able to stay positive, stay optimistic, stay happy, I think you'll have a much more fulfilling career and a fulfilling life. And, you know, I've inherited my positivity from my father. Me and my father just laugh at everything. We're just happy people. And, you know, I think it's helped me a lot, because I've had a lot of failures, setbacks in life. Investment banking, in fact, is about winning and losing every day. And if you sort of take that personally and take it to heart, I don't think you can come back and next day start playing as a gladiator again, because it's a pretty solo sport at the end of the day. It's a lonely life in the corporate world. And I think if you don't keep the positivity, you develop mental health issues. And to that extent, Radha, what you do in terms of exercise is great, because I think it builds that positivity, builds that whole, you know, self-image up, and you know, helps you cope with the stress of corporate world much more.
No, absolutely. And also it gives you the energy. But I love this point that you made that, you know, don't take yourself seriously. Learn to laugh at yourself. I think that's, you know, we people have forgotten in this whole rat race and the corporate world, we become so serious. And, you know, it's so this is just such an important point, which people completely forget about. What two tips would you like to share? I mean, you've spoken about such amazing things, but what two tips, if you had to give two tips to the viewers, and not only the women, even the men out there, what are the two tips that you would like to leave with the viewers and listeners?
So I think the first tip, and that what works for me the most, is that have a community of friends who have nothing to do with work. I think a lot of us in the corporate world not only just meet our colleagues at work, we also socialize with them after work. And then, you know, inevitably the conversation goes back to work situation and, you know, work events. I, through my, you know, through my exercise, my sport and other things, have a community of friends who are actually musicians, singers. I come from all walks of life who have not even any clue on what I do. They're like, what is investment banking? Do you invest in stocks? And I'm like, it's okay. It doesn't matter. Right. And that's great, because because when you meet, you discuss such diverse things, and, you know, what you do doesn't matter. And I think it's really important to free the mind. It's much like when we play a sport. when there's a golf coming, when there's a golf ball coming at you or a tennis ball coming at you, you stop thinking work. You just focus on the ball, right? And to get the shot back. Similarly, I think friends from different walks of life re-energize you. Younger friends re-energize you. They bring positivity. So I think that's what works for me. The fact that I can go on a short vacation or meet in the evenings with friends who have absolutely nothing to do with my work and don't care a damn what I do or, you know, what deal I won or what deal I lost. It doesn't matter to them. You know, they don't want to hear about it. So that's fabulous for me. The second thing, because I grew up in the mountains, I think that works for me is that don't take the outdoor away from your life. I think what happens with all of us, especially in cities like Bombay, which are so hot, we, you know, live from our home, which is air conditioned, to the car, to the workspace, which is all air conditioned. And I think the outdoor really clears your mind. Even if it's just a walk or sitting under a tree, if you can find a tree with a bench in Bombay, you know, just spending some time in the outdoor refreshes your mind. Spend time with nature. And I think you'll come out much more refreshed, much happier, much more relaxed. So those are the two things that's worked for me, Radha.
I love both your points. Having friends who are not only part of your corporate world, you know, also it helps you to just talk about other things and it just relaxes you so much and you have so much more fun and the outdoors.
Yes.
I loved both your points. Before we go, this is a popular demand from a lot of the viewers. So I'm starting a rapid fire section. And and you're the first guest who's going
to... Oh, I'm the first. Okay, let's go for it.
Yes, so you have to tell me a word that comes into your mind when I say these words, and we're only going to go for five words. Okay?
Cool, let's do it.
Okay. Exercise.
Endorphins.
Career.
Passion.
Family.
Backbone.
Joy.
Chocolate cake and chocolate ice cream. Anything to do with chocolate.
Woman.
Empowered.
I love it. Seriously, Manisha, it was great to have you on the show. So many points that you said, laugh at yourself, outdoors, you know, me time. I think so many takeaways for all of us. I found this talk really inspirational. Friends, I hope you found this talk as inspirational as I did. Loved having her on the show. You can find us on YouTube channel, hashtag ZipToFitness, Instagram account, ZipToFitness, and Spotify podcast and Apple iTunes podcast, ZipTalks. Thank you so much.